mention these trends of prescribing for elderly outpatients of a tertiary hospital in Dubai. I'm going to talk about the principles of drug prescribing for older patients, the factors to be considered, Beer's criteria and its significance in the clinical decision making, as well as a stop and the start criteria as well. Our little or small research carried out in Dubai Pharmacy College in a tertiary hospital in Dubai regarding the design of the research, the sample and the data collection, as well as our findings. Globally, the number of persons aged 60 years or over is expected almost to triple, increasing from 672 million in 2005 to nearly 1.9 billion by 2050. In developed countries, 20% of the population is aged 60 years or over and is projected to be 32% by 2050. These data were released in 2005 by the United Nations Economic and Social Affairs. In 2013, by Government of Dubai Community Development Authority, the elderly over 60 years age account for nearly 5% of total UAE population. Coming to the prescription for elderly. Prescribing for elderly is really a challenge, and there are many factors contributing to this challenge list actually. They cannot be ordered in 1 to 3 according to importance, but they are all contributing to the bad situation in which there is a prescriber, the healthcare provider, the pharmacist, or even at home, the caregiver for the elderly people. Effect of aging on the physiology of drug therapy and compliance to medication. As all of us, we know that the elderly people, they have different pharmacokinetics and pharmacodynamics response to medications. Compliance to medication is also highly affected by their perception of illness and their feeling that they do not come better by this medication, so maybe they stop it, maybe they stop it for financial issue, maybe they can forget for some cognitive impairment. Adverse events and adverse drug reactions are actually very significant a concern for the prescriber, such as falls and cognitive impairment, increasing the morbidity and the health resource utilization. Multiple comorbid state of an elderly patient is a challenge also, leading to polypharmacy. New drugs available each year with increasing off-label usage, and there are so many nutraceuticals now introduced in the market. And meanwhile, there is lack of evidence-based safety for these newly introduced items, and finally the medication cost. So to keep an optimal pharmacotherapy is to keep a balance between the overprescribing and the underprescribing by choosing the correct drug in a correct dose regimen and to be sure that the drug is targeting the appropriate condition and it is appropriate for the patient on an individualized basis. So there is a very nice quote, which is avoid the pill for every ill. It has to be followed, as well as always consider the non-pharmacologic therapy. Adverse drug reactions are responsible for 5 to 28% of acute geriatric hospital admission. In one study in UK, they found that 50% of the elderly people discharged at one time, they go back to the same hospital within 1 year due to adverse drug reactions from their prescribed list. But although it is reaching 28% of geriatric hospital admission, luckily greater than 95% of the ADRs in the elderly are predicted and 50% of them, they are considered preventable. How to prevent? The medication intake involves many steps: prescription, communication, dispensing, administration, and clinical follow-up. So many side effects can be, or adverse drug reactions can be prevented at the prescription level. Stop and start. Stop and start are strategies which have been recently developed to identify older patients at risk from adverse drug effects and to reduce the risk of initiating the drugs likely to cause adverse events. So STOP are standing for screening tool of older person's prescription. while START are letters standing for screening tool to alert doctors to write treatment. Let us go in a little bit detail about STOP and START to describe them. A STOP, it comprises 65 clinically significant criteria for potentially inappropriate prescribing in older people. To simply define the potentially inappropriate prescribing, is those medicines which have the use of medicines, these medicines, their risks outweigh their benefits in an elderly adult. Each criterion is accompanied by a concise explanation as to why the prescribing practice is potentially inappropriate. While START, it consists of 22 evidence-based prescribing indicators for the commonly encountered diseases in older people. So in very simple way, we can say that STOP is for the list of drugs which should be stopped, and START is for the list of the drugs which have to be started safely according to these guidelines. A third tool is a medication appropriateness index. Medication appropriateness index is like a checklist of questions which should be directed, the prescriber should direct to himself, as well as the pharmacist in community. Is it needed, this medication, the pros and cons of the medication, and the evidence base for pros and cons? Limit the range of drugs used for elderly people as to be included in a small formulary for elderly. There is a small BNF actually present in UK. I don't know if it's right now available in the Arab countries or no. The dosage regimen, there is one condition, start low and go slow. Are the directions correct and practical, so to keep them as simple and clear as possible? And to review regularly regarding whether it is there is unnecessary duplication or whether there is a possible drug-drug or drug-food or drug-condition interactions. And lastly, to be sure that the drug is the least expensive member among its alternatives, always use team and support. Beers criteria. What is Beers criteria? This is the tool actually used in our research. Beers criteria is an explicit USA consensus list. It is consisting the most widely used indicator to define the potentially inappropriate prescribing. It has been originally conceived by a geriatrician named Mark Beers, 1991, and then it has been updated 1997, 2003, 2012, and finally 2015. The 2012 update was the one used in our research presented today. Little information about Beers criteria. We have to know that it is a guide for identifying the medications for which risks outweigh benefits. It's not meant by any means to be punitive, and it's not meant to supersede the clinical decision ever, or any individual concern or values or needs. It underscores the importance of using a team approach and non-pharmacological approach. Other criteria such as STOP, START, and appropriateness index, also they should be used in a complementary manner. Let us also talk about Beers criteria in a little bit more detail. Beers criteria is divided into three categories, two in red and one in yellow. The two in red are for the potentially inappropriate medications. Here it's written PIM, for potentially inappropriate medication. First category is for the drugs which pose high risk or adverse effects or appear to have limited effectiveness, and meanwhile there are alternatives to these medications. And the second category is for the potentially inappropriate medications in specific people, in older people who have certain conditions, so this medication might increase the risk of having worsening the case. These two categories comprise 53 medications or medication classes that should be avoided. They should be totally avoided. They should not be prescribed for elderly people. And the third category, it is actually new. It is included in the 2012 update, and it includes 14 medications which should be used with caution because they may be associated with more risks than benefits. But keep in mind that these medications, they may be the only choice to be given to this patient in particular. So if the drug is carrying the label to be used in caution, the action to be taken is to slow down, monitor closely for effectiveness and adverse events. If it is carrying the label to potentially inappropriate, so stop and ask the questions whether it is important, this drug is essential, how to change, or if it is possible. Beers criteria, the evidence used is a quality of evidence is ranging between high, moderate, and low quality, and the strength of recommendation. recommendations were strong, weak, and insufficient. This is a grading system actually used by the American College of Physicians guidelines, and it is following the main grade scheme originally developed by Guyard et al. In 2012, update validated literature evaluation tool were used and were included in the list in order to support the recommendation. Regarding our study, steps followed in the study, examining the pattern of prescription medications therapeutic groups issued to elderly patients, evaluating the prescribing practice using the WHO prescribing indicator, identifying the extent of potentially inappropriate prescribing for elderly patients using the BEERS explicit criteria. Our study was a retrospective study. It was carried out using prescription issued to the geriatric patients 60 years and above, attending the various outpatient clinics of a tertiary hospital in Dubai. The prescriptions were collected during the period from 1st of January to 26th of February 2013. Certainly, the ethical committee of the institutional review board of the hospital, we get from it the ethical approval, as well as the ethical committee of the Dubai Pharmacy College. A total of 518 prescriptions for elderly outpatients were reviewed. A WHO prescriber indicator form was used for the data collection. This is just a sample of the form which has been modified by the research team to just count the, we'll see now what are the prescribing indicators measure. Prescribing indicators are data on age, gender, and possibly diagnosis, average number of drugs per prescription, percentage of drugs prescribed by generic name, percentage of encounters with an antibiotic and those with an injection, percentage of drugs prescribed from the essential drugs list. For the potential inappropriate medications, the extent of PIM prescribed for these elderly patients included in the 518 prescriptions examined were identified using the BEERS criteria 2012. Coming to our research results, patients are aged over 60 years, and notice that we have a significant amount, mashallah, 38 people were aged over 85 years old. The gender, regarding the gender, 301 were male, while 217 were female. Average number of drugs. Our study revealed polypharmacy, and polypharmacy means that deviating from the WHO standard. WHO standard is from 1.6 to 1.8 per prescription, and we found that the prescriptions contained average of 3.7, but you can notice from the table that a high and significant number of prescriptions contained more than 10 prescriptions, and 32, 6, 1, about 40 prescriptions, they contained more than 10 medication per one prescription, which is far away from the WHO standard. Regarding the therapeutic classes used, 46% account for cardiovascular drugs, 39.1% for vitamins and minerals, 32% for analgesics, we have 33% for the GIT, 23% anti-diabetic medication, 14% were diuretics, which we may account also in some way to cardiovascular sometimes, and the rest are various anti-allergic and others classes of medication. We compared the women versus men regarding the consumption of medication. Only two classes had significance. Analgesics and vitamins have significance only for women, for sure, consuming more vitamins and more analgesics than men. But all the rest of the classes showed no significance between gender significance. Percentage of medicines prescribed by generic name, 90.4% of drugs were prescribed in their generic names, only 9.6% appeared in brand names, and regarding the drug list, all the drugs were prescribed from the UAE essential drug list. Nothing was off-label. Encounters containing injection were 12.9% among all, while those containing antibiotics were 10.8% among all, which are less than the WHO standard. They are complying with the WHO standard in this regard. For the potentially inappropriate medicine, our findings revealed that 85% were appropriate, while about 15% of the medication prescribed in such tertiary hospital in such period of study were inappropriate. These 15% are further divided into 7.5% to be completely avoided, falling in the first or second category of Pierce list, and 7.2% to be used with caution. A further analysis of this inappropriateness in order to identify the classes most commonly prescribed for elderly, 44% account for anticholinergics, 26% for pain medications, 10% and 10% for neuro and GIT medications, and 5% and 5% for antithrombotics and anti-infective. For the drugs which are used with caution, or carrying the label to be used with caution in elderly adults, the main issue is to prescribe aspirin for primary prevention of cardiac events in people over 80 years old. 46% were there, although it is not recommended by Beers criteria. 18% for antipsychotics, 14% the yellow color for dabigatran, which is also sharing aspirin for the bleeding, and the rest for other medications. Here it's just a table showing that there are strong recommendations to avoid some drugs found in our list. The non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, for example, the one in the middle, we found naproxen, diclofenac, they are present in more than 10 prescriptions without any gastroprotection, although there is strong recommendation to avoid. Here is the rest, aspirin and dabigatran, they have to be used with caution also. And let us go in brief for the background why these drugs are potentially inappropriate. And we can just link the red color words because of the time. Bleeding for NSAIDs, constipation and confusion for anticholinergics, orthostatic hypotension for tricyclic antidepressants, benzodiazepines, sure cognitive impairment, which may lead to falls and fracture, antispasmodic anticholinergic, nitrofurantoin, pulmonary toxicity, dipyridamol for orthostatic hypotension, and the metoclopramide, well-known extrapyramidal side effects may be more grave or more worse in elderly people. Aspirin and dabigatran are the main issue of the medications used in caution because of bleeding. Actually, there is here in the last row, dabigatran, they are showing 80% more bleeding compared with the age-matched counterparts on warfarin. This is a study, clinical study, which gives an evidence included in the 2012 update. The key messages which can be excluded from this presentation is that number of medications per prescription should be minimized to the least possible, avoid pill for every ill. Anticholinergics are the most common inappropriately prescribed medications for elderly. Use of the non-COX selective NSAID has to be limited and the gastroprotection is a must. The clinical practice of recommending aspirin for the primary prevention of cardiac events in elderly more than 80 years old is not proper and it should be better avoided. Warfarin is safer than dabigatran in elderly people over 75 years old. Here, this is the site for the American Geriatric Society. If someone is interested, you can go to the site and just in the left menu, you can find pocket card. It is a printable version of the Beers criteria if someone like to purchase. On the same site, also there is mobile apps. Now the smartphone is the one working, so mobile apps are there. The mobile app is valid for 1 year. And the news, the very recent news just issued 22nd of October, 15 days before, is that Geriatric Society offers alternatives to Beers drug. So the list of potentially inappropriate medication listed in Beers criteria, now they have alternatives. And these alternatives are present free access online. You can go to just the site of American Journal of the American Geriatric Society to find it published online, all the alternatives to be given in case of potential inappropriateness. This is the role mainly of the prescriber, who is the physician, but also it is the role of the pharmacist, the community pharmacy, especially the healthcare provider, the caregiver, and all people who are responsible for taking care of a geriatric person. Coming to the end of my slide, I'd like to thank you all for listening to my presentation. And before thanking you, I have to thank my team. Actually, I added the slide, but it has not been included in my presentation. I have to thank my research team, Dr. Marwa Khalil, Khadija Nawar, Dalia Alghis, and Fatma Mahdi, our graduate students in Dubai Pharmacy College. And I have to thank my parent university, Cairo University first, because I am belonging to Dubai Pharmacy College here, but I am a Cairo University graduate. Thank you for your.
Thank you. to Dr. Amina. It was very informative, very interesting talk. Doctor.
Thank you, Amina. I think this is a green curriculum for you. This is a green curriculum, actually, because you introduce and you must talk this topic to replace instead of increase and to make it safe. Thank you.
Thank you. We will open the space for one question. Geriatric medicine and polypharmacy is a very hot topic, and it saves a lot in economy in addition to better health for adults.
Just one comment. According to BIS criteria, I think the elderly avoid drugs and take a couple of beers to go to bed.
I wish that works. You can write it as a recommendation, doctor. It can be added to the 2018 update. Any question? No. Thank you.